award-winning jazz saxophone player Grover Washington Jr. died overnight at the age of 56 after suffering an apparent heart attack.
It happened shortly after Washington taped a performance for this broadcast. Whether playing the national anthem at NBA games in his adopted hometown of Philadelphia or wowing crowds at packed venues around the country, Grover Washington Jr. was a jazz man for our time. Born in Buffalo, New York in 1943, he began playing the sax at the age of 10 and entered the national spotlight in 1971 with a soulful rendering of Marvin Gaye's Inner City Blues. Now, 10 years later, Washington won a double Grammy for one of the year's biggest hits, Just the Two of Us. That was with Bill Withers on the vocal. Remember that one? It was followed by a series of gold and platinum albums in the 80s and 90s as Washington honed an expressive, accessible style on all his own.
And one that he certainly treated us to, and all of us here at the Saturday Early Show were stunned and, of course, saddened by this sudden turn of events. We want to express our deepest sympathy to Grover Washington's wife and his children, his family, his friends. We considered whether to broadcast the performance that we taped yesterday, but Grover Washington was a musician, a very fine musician, a compassionate man, a very gentle man. And his friends and colleagues tell us they think he would want to be heard.
In fact, as we walked around sad yesterday, his manager told us, don't feel sad. He died after doing something he loved, play music. So here in his final performance is Grover Washington Jr.
I'm not
Washington Jr. with the largest marquee in the world, the Plaza Hotel.
Certainly
outside.
Deserving.
Welcome back to the Saturday Early Show. He was here yesterday afternoon. We were talking to him. A nice guy, a great guy. He was telling us he was a classically trained musician. Mm-hmm. He started, I guess, professionally at the age of 12.
Right.
And in February, he had a new CD coming out of arias.
Of arias. And what's special about that CD is, remember I asked him about the saxophones. He plays several kinds. He plays four of them. He calls them voices. And he said, every song needs a different voice. And he was so pleased about the arias coming out. And he'd be using all the different saxophones and just bringing out a music that you don't normally associate with a saxophone.
Yeah. He was saying this album would bring him full circle from his classical training to this. And about him, the man, I mean, in speaking to him, again, we didn't spend a whole lot of time with him. He seemed just so happy with life. Mm-hmm. He was very proud of his kids. He talked about his wife. He said, I met my wife there.
Right.
He was so happy about that.
Totally. And he's very, very proud of Philadelphia, in fact, which was his adopted. He was born in Buffalo, but then he lived in Philadelphia. And a lot of people in Philadelphia know him for his charitable work, for his community work. He has worked with young children, teaching them, underprivileged children, teaching them about music, playing with them, helping them appreciate. And look at the move. Look at those kids. 1995. And Grover Washington Jr. made us move like that.
He certainly did.
He truly, truly moved us.
He was also a big basketball fan. Was a good good friend of Dr. J. He wrote a song in honor of Dr. J a few years ago, Let It Flow.
He's just a wonderful man. He actually also celebrated his birthday last week. As we were saying goodnight yesterday, I said to him, you know, best wishes. He did the same, pulled me toward him, kissed me on the cheek, and said, from my home to yours.
What a great guy.
Forget.
The late Grover Washington Jr. Our condolences, of course, go out to Grover Washington Jr.'s family. We'll be back.
Christmas brunch.
That's right. Mm-hmm. Okay, we're going to leave you now with more music from the late Grover Washington Jr. performing one of his signature songs, Soul Strut. We'll see you.
Bye-bye.